Welcome back. Before you know it, winter will hit, but for now we have some beautiful autumn weather, which means it's a great day to take FSD out for a spin by the lake and the downtown streets. Today's a very simple drive, but as you see, it becomes somewhat tricky with a challenging scenario that measures FSD's capabilities in high traffic situations. We're going to start off on some tight residential streets before we hit some busier roads. As you can see, we've got very sunny conditions here, and that's one of the things that FSD has improved quite a bit in the last couple of years. With the sun going straight into the cameras, there used to be ghosting and some false positives there, which would lead to some immediate braking. They've resolved that by and far. And as you can see right there, we did a nice smooth left turn onto this residential street. As you can see, it's very tight. We've got cars that are parked on the left and right. No issue for FSD. Do a nice gentle right turn there. As you can see, we've got some pylons there that are blocking some of the lane, so FSD's got to take a little bit more time, go safely around there, and then presents us again nice and evenly in this lane. We have no oncoming traffic, so it can stay in the middle of the lane. No issues with the vehicles on the left and right. Now what we're going to do is we're going to come up here to a bit of a blind left. We're going to be turning right. So FSD is going to have to inch forward until the cameras can clearly see. And as you can see on the display there, there's no vehicles coming. Very good acceleration there, and it does a fantastic job with that. And I'll speed up the camera here, as FSD does a very good job. As you can see, beautiful conditions today. Now we're just going to speed up. We've got an advanced screen, so FSD will move forward there nice and smooth. And we're going to be doing one more left turn here onto a very busy road. This is Lakeshore Boulevard in downtown Toronto, which runs parallel to the lake. We've got our green light. It's keeping good distance between the truck and myself. Nice and smooth. Now let's see if it stays in the left lane, if it goes into the middle lane. I don't have to drive or turn left anytime soon. And as you can see, it does the right move there and it puts me into the middle lane. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna speed up the camera here. Now what you need to do is just pay a little bit of attention to my map there. You can't see it yet, but eventually what's going to happen is FSD is going to have to get into the left lane, and because that is the only lane that's going to be able to exit to get onto the highway, which is where I'm being routed to currently. Now I'm speeding it up here just because it's taking a bit of time, but also just to give you a sense of the flow of the vehicles around. As you can see, we've got lots of vehicles that are on the left. Got lots of vehicles that are inching up on the right as well, and we're not progressing too fast. What FSD needs to do right now is it has to get into that left turn lane. And what's happened now is we're in a position, as you can see on my display, is that there's just a huge, just like a giant conga line of vehicles there on the left, and it's making it near impossible for FSD to go and move in there. And what I would really like to see is FSD be a little bit more aggressive and try to make a move, sort of angle in and try to push its way in. Now, of course, it can only do that if it's safe. But we're at the position now, as you can see on my display, is that we're going to miss this left turn. And I'm not intervening. I'm letting FSD try to do it and see if it'll make that move just before the end, because sometimes it does that. But as you can see, we've got lots of vehicles now that are trying to squeeze in from the right. So this is very difficult for FSD to try to manage. It's got to take into consideration the vehicle straight in front of it, the vehicles that are rushing in from the right, and all the vehicles on the left that are not letting me in. So let's see what happens. Again, I'm going to wait right until the end. We've got a green light now. Let's see what happens. See how these other vehicles are squeezing in right now? It's going to make it basically impossible for FSD to move over unless it's very aggressive. Okay, vehicles are now moving forward. Let's see what happens. As you see, we've got a solid line there. And then, you know, once we get to that solid line, we're going to pretty much miss out on that. So what's going to have to happen is I'm going to have to disengage, because look right there. There's a police officer on my right. So I'm not going to drive over that line myself. As you can see, we're going to have to go, still bend a bit to the left, but I'm going to have to take over here. And again, you can see there's that barrier, so there's no way I was going to make it over to that left turn. So that was unfortunate. So hopefully in the future, you know, as an improvement, hopefully there'll be a little bit more aggression, or it gets ahead of those situations. I know sometimes it's difficult. You're driving there and then suddenly the lane completely closes up with lots of traffic. But, you know, as a result of that, we have to do a complete rerouting here, which is okay. Again, it's a beautiful day here, and I can drive on these more scenic streets that might actually have some interesting conditions as well. As you can see, we've got lots of pedestrians. See that car there? Just stop there because of the pedestrians. FSD had no issues going around them. Very good job there. And when we're driving on these winding roads here, FSD also does a very good job of managing the auto speed offset. I know I've had issues before on roads that go about 40 kilometers an hour, and FSD is just, burning up to 60 and really speeding. But when it comes to these winding roads, the auto speed offset does a very good job, and it manages it the speed very well. We need to get into the right turn lane. And as you can see, FSD gets in there a little bit late. A little bit late, should have gotten there a little bit earlier, but it got in there. Okay, so now it's gonna have to turn right. I wonder if FSD's being cautious just because of those pedestrians there. We've got some vehicles here coming straight at us. FSD's just gonna wait for them to pass. And let's see it. Yep, and does the right turn there. It might have been able to be a little bit more aggressive there as well, but it did manage that very safely, so I'm okay with that. As you can see, we've got some winding roads here. As you can see on the map, we've got a few bends up ahead. All right, doing a good job there. No issues with the pedestrians on the sidewalks. You can see we have a stadium in front. This is where our football and soccer team in Toronto plays. They're actually going to be playing some World Cup games there. The next Soccer World Cup. All right, see that vehicle slowing there on the right. No issues, FSD will comfortably go around. Nice smooth bend to the right. This is very comfortable. I really have no concerns when FSD is driving like this. Nice and smooth. Okay, we've got a stop sign here, but look, this vehicle's stopping now after, and they're letting some people out. Let's see how long it takes FSD to determine if it wants to go around. And as you can see, FSD will now signal and go right around that vehicle. Nice and smooth. Very good job. Now, pay attention to what we're seeing going up. There's going to be a little bit of indecisiveness on FSD's part, and we're going to go see why. Okay, as you see, we're slowing down here. Look at that vehicle there on the right, that white vehicle there. FSD is trying to determine if that person's going to be driving left in front of me. Are they making a left turn? Are they making a right turn? As you can see by my wheel, FSD is kind of struggling with that, a little bit of that indecisiveness there. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take over right there just to move the car along. And again, what I really should have done is just decisively signal left, because we're supposed to be turning here in the left turn lane. But it was struggling with that, and I think it was just because of the mixture of oncoming traffic as well as that white vehicle on the right. So now we're going to be doing our left turn here. Take a look at this now. Look at the acceleration there. FSD is tired of driving slow and gets into the middle lane and just zooms right by these people. I would have done the exact same thing, actually. It's a good pass, but what I want to see it do is drop the speed now, and it's actually doing the right thing. Look, it went back into the left lane to pass this vehicle, but look, it slowed down very well. That's exactly what I want to see from FSD. If it's going to accelerate and go past vehicles, it can't stay above the speed limit by a large margin, and in this case, it slowed down and did the right thing. All right, just speeding along here. Here's another fantastic interaction of FSD and the vehicles there. See this vehicle there? Swerves out at the last minute, goes in front of me. FSD does a great job reacting to that. It braked well, it didn't have to slam on the brakes. It got ahead of that, and it was a nice pronounced but smooth braking job, so it did a very good job. That's a, one of the highlights of FSD is that it's very safe and it reacts very well to other vehicles in front of it. And you'll see that just up ahead in a couple of moments. But again, what I'm going to do is just speed up the camera here, because as you can see, FSD is doing a very good job here managing the flow of traffic. As you can see, it went into the middle lane there, did a good job, so it got out of the passing lane, which I'm very happy with. If I'm not passing cars, I'm very happy that it does that. Now take a look here. Again, we're staying in the middle lane. We've got that elevated highway above us. We've had issues with that before and GPS signals. This time we're going in the other direction. As you can see, it's handling everything very smoothly. Now what's going to come up here is you're going to start seeing that cars are going to be moving left and right in front of me and squeezing in front of me, and we'll see how FSD manages that. You see here, we've got a lot of vehicles here in this lane on the right that are going to be trying to squeeze in front of us. Let's see what FSD does. Again, just moving forward nice and patiently. See that? We've got vehicles that are merging. Look at that. We've got vehicles that are merging both on the left side and the right side. So FSD is just doing the smart thing. It's keeping its distance. You know, this is when I feel comfortable knowing that I think it can do a really good job under full autonomy in the future, in the near future. I really believe that. All right, to summarize this drive, by far FSD still feels comfortable with most driving scenarios. It reacts very well to traffic and suddenly stopping vehicles. Where it still fell a little bit short in this drive is trying to merge into those lanes with heavy traffic. I'd like to see it try to be slightly more aggressive. Well, that's, I mean, easy for me to say as I can break certain rules to bully my way into a lane. Is this something that maybe FSD will eventually learn to do? Maybe when we get to version 13? A fully autonomous vehicle, though, should have that ability, but only if it's safe. So thanks for watching. Simple ask, if you enjoyed or learned anything from this video, smash the like, and feel free to subscribe if you want to see more videos of my Hardware 3 Tesla. See you on the roads.